Hello, I'm Brendan. Last month, we learned how to use jOOQ and Gradle to streamline database interactions. Today, with the help of some open source libraries, we'll build a simple jOOQ application for SQLite on Android 4.3 using Android Studio. I've used this toolchain for some time, but it is still fairly bleeding edge, so your mileage may vary. Let's get started. To get started, let's create a new Android virtual device using the AVD manager. We'll be using 4.3, mainly because Intel hasn't yet released a hardware-accelerated execution manager for KitKat, and in order to reach any semblance of usability, we prefer to use vPro whenever possible. If you have a physical device, this step can be also omitted. To take advantage of native virtualization, first ensure that you've updated all the packages in Android's SDK manager, then install the Intel driver manually. Finally, check to enable host GPU emulation. First, we'll need the jOOQ dependency on Maven Central, along with the Gradle jOOQ plugin just like before. SQLite implements a subset of the SQL standard, which is tightly integrated within Android. During the code generation phase, we'll use Taro Saito's SQLite JDBC driver, and then switch over to SQL Droid once we're on the device. Since Android doesn't expose a JDBC driver for public use, this is the main setback for integrating jOOQ directly on Jelly Bean. However, jOOQ is integration tested against Serial's driver, which will allow us to substitute them painlessly. Here, I'm also including a dependency on the JavaX reference implementation for JSR 250 to support annotations in our generated code. And finally, we'll use a little tool called SQLite Asset Helper, which saves us some boilerplate and migrates our database file to an app-friendly location on the device. I went ahead and pulled a contacts file off my own device. We'll store it in the assets folder and drop that in with our sources. Ordinarily, we would create the database programmatically, but depending on how you deal with migrations, you may well ship a factory database within your app. We'll do it this way for demonstration. I'll paste a link to the build script below, which should work as is, substituting your own database under the JDBC URL. We'll write some code momentarily, but first let's generate our sources. As we'll see in a while, jOOQ works seamlessly on many databases, but the real win here is for good testing on a number of levels. Here we have a piece of code running on two separate implementations of Java, with two different drivers, two different build tools, and two different operating systems, speaking one SQL dialect, and everything just fits together with a little bit of glue, because someone wrote their test cases. It's a miracle. I've never appreciated the importance of testing more. In the next screencast, we will explore unit testing and mocking in depth using RoboElectric, so please stay tuned. Android Studio still is an experimental IDE, but considering it was released only last year, it has a surprising number of good qualities. If you're an Eclipse user, you may wish to try it out, with the caveat that NDK isn't yet supported. With the release of IntelliJ App Code and rapid iteration on the Android team, native C should quickly follow. If you do need NDK support, you can still write, package, and deploy using Studio. One of the features I really enjoy in Studio is the ability to easily filter through logcat entries with 0.4.5. As a new Android developer, I would spend hours tailing the log, searching for entries related to my app. Android Studio not only provides an interface for logging, but makes it simple to identify which ones belong to us. Since it's based on the IntelliJ Community Edition, it supports many of the features for IntelliJ. One of my favorite plugins is IdeaVim, which supports VI functionality for navigation. First off, let's bootstrap a new instance of our SQL Droid driver, then use that to create a stand-in JDBC connection for jOOQ. This part is a little clumsy, since Android really doesn't play well with JDBC, whereas jOOQ depends on it. Typically, we prefer to handle database interactions asynchronously on Android to avoid ANRs, but here, we'll just place our query directly on the critical path to demonstrate the idea. Once we've established a connection from the driver manager, we can go straight ahead and write our query. I'll select my friend's first names, estimate how cool they are based on how many times I've dialed them, their telephone numbers, and then remove the area codes of the alleged. Just like before, writing a jOOQ query is just like writing native SQL. Here, SQLite is no different, with support for many conventional SQL idioms. Some advanced features like insert or update, replace, upsert, merge, and unduplicate key are awaiting implementation or are unavailable in SQLite. Nevertheless, for most read and write operations, jOOQ passes with flying colors. Another key feature in Android Studio is the layout editor, which renders XML and allows us to preview app layouts on a number of common screens, although I found it isn't always perfect. Studio will also manage our resources and automatically generate Java bindings in nearly real time, do markup validation, auto-completion, and all the standard features you'd come to expect from an XML editor. Finally, I'd like to highlight an important part of the Android toolchain, DDMS. Debugging works in the emulator or over the wire, and Studio makes it as simple as setting a breakpoint and pressing F9 to debug in an instant. While some have reported significant compilation latency for larger apps compared to Eclipse, this isn't always a bad thing. I like to meditate in the red dot. Otherwise, you could take the extra time to joust in desk chairs or go climb a mountain. So, it could be snappier. The debugger also supports generating a heap dump for profiling, which is especially useful for diagnosing your memory footprint. Let's review what we've done. We started out with a database dump, exposed it to jOOQ CodeGen, which generated a schema in Java using the serial driver. Next, we wrote our mobile code using the generated sources and submitted it to the Android build system, which optimized our sources and built a custom APK for our virtual device. SQLite Asset Helper streamed our database file from the kernel and wrote it to the local storage, enabling us to establish a JDBC connection through SQL Droid. So there you have it, jOOQ on Android. Sadly, none of these people are very cool, because it seems like I've never contacted any of them. Maybe that just goes to show what a great friend I am. I'm Brendan, and this is Android Studio. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time.